Hey Cancer, welcome to your mid-monthly reading for February 2021. My name is Johanna. Welcome to Tenacious Soul. We are going to get into some general messages for you guys. So take what resonates, leave the rest. You can always check out your sun, your moon, and your rising sign. Let's see where we go. Make sure you guys like and subscribe if you enjoy these messages. If you're new here, welcome. All right. Let's see, what does Cancer need to know? Cancer mid-February, what's happening? So we have the fifth chakra, which is the throat chakra, Archangel Gabriel. We have hostilities, number 26. And we have Goddess of the Moon, number 52. Then we have number 46, the Thinking Man. Some of you aren't communicating how you really feel, and I feel like it's almost like causing conflict with, almost like within you. It's like you're thinking a lot about this situation, could even be about a person. But I feel like there needs to be some communication. You need to follow your intuition when it comes to some sort of situation. There's some sort of conflict here with this hostilities. Like almost like a need to defend yourself. Okay. So, Cancer. What does Cancer need to know for mid-February? Cancer, what's going on? Okay, so we have the Emperor. The Queen of Cups. The Knight of Cups. Empress, Seven of Cups, Three of Cups, lots of cups. Strength, Eight of Wands, King of Wands. Bottom of the deck, the Eight of Cups. Okay. So I feel like some of you are moving forward. I feel like there's somebody in your life, somebody who you have a lot of love for. This is kind of more in like the recent past. I feel like almost currently you're a little bit maybe possibly confused or overwhelmed with this situation. With the Three of Cups here, I feel like maybe needing to communicate with friends or resort to your community for support during this time. We're going to clarify this, but there is a strength to move forward with possibly this. I think this King of Wands and this Emperor are the same person. So there could be some sort of reconciliation coming in. Like if you separated from this person, possibly, there could be some sort of reconciliation with that Three of Cups. But there's kind of like, I feel like something must have happened here. Could have been a third party. Could also be that this is somebody new. Like, let's see. I feel like this King of Wands and the Emperor are similar. Similar energy to them. So what is this Emperor in the recent past for Cancer? Okay, so it was somebody new. I feel like possibly somebody was trying to seek some clarity on this situation. Like, it's with somebody new in your life, but it's like, I don't know, there's like some hesitation around taking that leap of faith. What is this Queen of Cups in the recent past for Cancer here? Wow. The Empress, the Star, the Four of Cups, and the Moon. So you definitely are this Empress, and they are your Emperor. You were wanting some sort of like wish fulfillment, and I don't know if you maybe didn't see this person, or you felt like there was something off about this situation. Like you felt like there was some sort of an illusion, or you possibly fell for the illusion. But there was something here that didn't sit right. With that Four of Cups, it's like something wasn't feeling... I feel like it looked like it had a lot of potential, and then maybe it just like wasn't really what you thought it was going to be. With the Devil down here at the bottom of the deck, there could have been something kind of like some sort of an illusion or toxicity. What is this Knight of Cups? Or you could just have very deep emotions for this person. We have the Four of Swords with the Knight of Cups with the Eight of Wands. Like somebody didn't take the action that they should have. Some of you could have been waiting for this opportunity to come in and it just like never did. There was something with regards to this relationship that there was like some lack of clarity. For some of you, this person could have hurt you, or you were needing to heal something. Clarify the Empress here in the current energy. Five of Swords and the Hermit. So there definitely is some sort of like conflict here that you were keeping to yourself with that Hermit. Again, it's like with the throat chakra and the hostilities, it's like there's something that you need to communicate here. And I feel like you're kind of holding back with the Hanged Man at the bottom of the deck, and you're carrying this burden almost like within this connection. You're holding on to this, or you keep holding on to this. What is this Seven of Cups? Sorry about that noise. I don't know if you guys can hear that, but I'm in my basement, so you know. What is the Seven of Cups here in the current energy? What is this Seven of Cups? The Lovers. Yeah, some of you don't know what to do about this situation. Like, you don't know... I feel like you just need to trust your intuition, but you're keeping things to yourself because you maybe don't know how to handle this situation. There could have been a third party somehow here. Let's see what this Three of Cups is. What is this Three of Cups? Magician. Tell me more about this Three of Cups, please. This is a lot of cards. So what I'm getting for some of you is some of you need to decide whether you want to continue on this path with this Emperor. I feel like this person could be very stubborn or very stuck in their ways. Like some of you are needing to decide, are you going to move forward or are you going to become single? Like, are you going to continue in this relationship? And I feel like some of you have been trying to manifest this reconciliation with this person. I feel like there was some sort of falling out, but I feel like you have a lot of love for this person, or there's a lot of love between you. There's a very strong connection, obviously, with the Emperor and the Empress here. And so it's like, it's almost like trying to figure out, I feel like you know the answer, listen to your intuition. But you're holding back. Some of you need to communicate how this made you feel. What is this strength card here in the near future for Cancer? Seven of Cups. So this is like the strength to make a decision, the strength to move forward. I feel like having the strength to look at this situation. We have the Knight of Cups at the, or the Knight of Pentacles at the bottom. So this is like moving forward slowly. I feel like you're, it's gonna taking you a lot of strength to kind of move through the illusion, or move through kind of the lack of clarity that sits in this relationship, or even just like how you feel. Clarify the Eight of Wands. What is this Eight of Wands in the near future? Justice with the Page of Cups at the bottom. So somebody could be communicating an apology. It could be this Emperor. Somebody wants to like fix a situation, or they want to maybe like come clean. They're realizing maybe you make them happy. There's a lot of love between you and this person, but something went wrong. It's not really telling me what it was. Clarify this King of Wands. What is this King of Wands? Seven of Swords. So I feel like whatever this person was maybe withholding from you, I feel like that's going to come out. This person could be gaining the strength to communicate with you and apologize to you in the near future. Like this could be them with that strength card, is like having the strength to express. Because I do feel like there's a strong connection, but there's something that happened here. Tell me more about this King of Wands, Seven of Swords. King of Wands, Seven of Swords, please. Five of Cups. Yeah, they have regrets about how they treated you, how they acted towards you in this situation. I feel like they've been watching you. They feel very connected to you, but I feel like for some of you, like you guys walked away. Some of you could have a different person in your life right now. Possibly like this King of Pentacles that's shown up a couple times. I feel like this Emperor possibly wants to start something new. Like they're not ready to give up on this situation. So let's see, what else does Cancer need to know? What else does Cancer need to know for mid-February? What else? That's too many. Okay, that one wanted to come out. We have Waking the Lion. That's that like King of Wands energy. That's 19. And 24, Let It Go. I almost feel like you possibly walked away from someone and it woke up the lion. It made somebody realize, or somebody walked away from you and it made you realize about them. So letting go, or let it go, sorry, at the bottom of the deck here. So it says forgiveness, healing resentment, shedding the role of the eternal martyr, letting go of victimhood, cutting the ties that bind you to a destructive story, releasing pain so you can move on into the lesson it offers, relinquishing the need to be right. And then Waking the Lion says boldness, the courage to move forward even without knowing the way, facing that which is difficult or painful, the audacity to step into the unknown. Yeah, I feel like somebody, somebody let something go here, and it's like, I think there was a lot of like, there needs to be forgiveness in this situation, I feel, for things to be able to move forward. But I also feel like somebody had a lot of fear in this situation, which held them back. It could have held this Emperor back from truly expressing their feelings, their true feelings and desires. Let's see, what is the healing mantra? It's way too many. Can I get a healing mantra for Cancer, please? mid-February. What is the healing mantra? Inviting ecstasy. We have, I am worthy of all the pleasure my heart desires. So whatever you want, whatever you're trying to manifest, whatever that is for you, I feel like you're just realizing your worth and realizing that you deserve love. You deserve whatever it is that you're trying to achieve. So that is what I have for you, Cancer. Hopefully that was helpful for you. Let me know down in the comments below. Make sure you guys like and subscribe as well if you enjoy these messages, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.